TV Entertainment with our
Good evening. Thank you for introducing
yourself.
My name is Carlo.
You know the film.
I'm pretty excited. It's not every day you leave work to come to this film. I'm not where you can let your bottom end down. And, so I don't think I've been to any social function. I've been in these 2 years. I've not really been to something else. It's just a time for me to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. All the best. I mean, for you to have been mentioned and nominated, it means you did a lot of hard work. Everyone is taking that. I always say that I want to be certificate. I might not get to it there, but it lets people know that this person knows what he's doing. So I wish everyone the best. And when I say award, I mean the nomination. As soon as you're nominated, it means that you've done something exceptional. So whoever wins is simply the first award we know.
Brooklyn industry,
it's come see, come serve. Like this, like that. Technologically, sophisticated wise, equipment to use but we still need to work on the substance. It says that our stories are not so strong. The ones before were very practical, so they just lifted them out of real-life experiences. And that's why they resonated with people all over the world, especially African people of African descent, Jamaicans, African resonated very well with our stories before.
Now our stories are heard of, those are coming political,
creating an agenda of aping the culture that we went through. These are things that will be touched upon. So, but the main thing that both parts, both Hollywood past and Hollywood present, are in dire need of is the business head of it, which is distribution. Intellectual property, getting property, royalties and stuff like that. From which, if these two, because at the moment, producers are working based on the passion and the love for the industry, it's not that they make that much. If they hardly make enough to bring back, so it's just a passion that keeps them. But this other aspect of talking about distribution and intellectual property, once that is put in place, they have to see. We can easily surpass Hollywood in the next 10-20 years, if that's possible. So look what the music industry is doing, that should give you a picture of what our potential is, our Nigerian's potential.
Thank you very much.
They need to start in the house.
Okay, my name is Steve. I'm president of the Air Force.
Wow, that's amazing. How excited are you about the event this evening? Considering it's the 17th edition.
It's the 17th edition. We've done this for 17 years. About 9 out of 8. And everyone miles up. We've done in South Africa, in Lagos, in Africa. I'm proud that this has been successful. It has endured so far, and it's a proof that Africa can be proud of, that Africa can celebrate, that we have our own Oscars. And you can see from the people around here, from all over the country, what the African diaspora is doing for the world of Africa, from the continent of Africa, as far as celebrating the African story, the art of storytelling that we all know that. So I think that I'm a dog and I am proud to have been associated with our rightful perception. And I recall that very first year in Bayelsa, year ago, in 2005. You know, we started small, but look at where I'm at today. It's been consistent, reliable, it's credible. The jury is an important component of ABBA, and you can see that the 12-man jury is all over the world, from every part of it, of the world, from Europe, from the Americas, from West Africa, etc. I've done very well to ensure that everything that comes out of the ABBA is credible. Credibility is important. You can win and run with your victory in any of the categories. So that, for me, is something to celebrate.
Speaking of growth in African
music,
what do you have to say about growth in African
music? We've come a long way. There were times that the technical areas were a major issue, but not anymore. There will always be aspects for improvement, sound, visual effects, cinematography. But we have access to all the equipment. We have African technicians and professionals who are also being nominated at the Oscars, who are doing very well, who can compete, you know, with their peers elsewhere in Hollywood, in Europe. So there's no excuse for us anymore. Maybe funding to an extent, but then we are also there. Now that our teams are getting, you know, to the Oscar level, I think that we have come up with it and we are there already. What we need to do now is to conquer the global stage. Yes, we should hold our own base very well, but we should also compete. That's the beauty of filmmaking. Because cinema has no local language, it's not cinema language. Beautiful storytelling, good technical quality, and then show the world that part of you that you want really to appreciate. That's what filmmaking is about. And I think that the concept of African cinema is changing. Be consistent, stay true to your dreams. Do not give in to COVID-19 or any other challenges, because this is a beautiful continent. We are resonant. We are.
I'm asking you. Wonderful people, my name is Eniola Badmos, and of course I'm using this medium to remind you guys to please subscribe to Eniola Badmos TV on YouTube, so you can get to what different trending news, you can get to what different entertainment updates, and of course all the news going on around the world. Guys, do not forget to turn on your notification so you can get to watch all of our content. Thank you so much, guys. And
Eniola Badmos TV Entertainment.